All right. My next guest began his career almost 20 years ago in the Home Alone movies. Starting next Friday, he can be seen in the new movie Saved. Please welcome Macaulay Culkin. Thanks so much for coming.
No, thanks for having me. It's like 11, what was it, 24 hours ago, I think I found out I was going to be here or something.
Oh, that's cool. Yeah, it was nice of you to come by and help us out.
I should have brought my good razor.
You could have helped us out. I would have gone a little faster.
Exactly.
I think you'd look good if half your head was shaved. What do you think, crowd?
That's what everyone's saying.
No, that's all right. You know, I want to ask you something. I actually, we've worked together a little bit outside of this project here, The Late Night Show, and I never got to ask you this before, and it must be annoying, but you must still get people that, even though you've achieved a lot of great things acting as an adult, you must still get people that can't let go of the Home Alone thing and come up to you and ask for the Home Alone face.
Yeah, no, I get it a good amount. And I just basically say to them, you know what, it's sad. You don't want to see it. Be like, it's just really pathetic. He's old. You know, what happened?
Right,
you know?
Right. Now, that's the good. That's the good.
Exactly.
People that are like, what do you expect? Like, you'll be doing that in clubs, going around.
Exactly,
doing that,
give people the wrong impression. Yeah. Exactly.
You actually still have a scar on you, I've been told, that you got from Joe Pesci shooting Home Alone. Is that true?
It's on my finger. Yeah, it's actually one of the scenes. You know, they hang me up on the closet door or something. They said, I'm going to bite each one of your fingers off one at a time. And during rehearsal, he actually bit me. And it broke the skin and everything. I'm a little 9-year-old boy, and he's going around biting them, you know?
Yeah.
And I still have the scar. I didn't even realize it until recently. And there it is, the little thing.
Now, did you get... Did you get mad when Joe Pesci bit you?
Yes, I did. I got really mad at him. I was like, I don't care how many Oscars you have or whatever. And like, what are you biting a 9-year-old? What the heck's wrong with you? So
I love the idea of you just blowing up on the set of that movie.
Well, I'm like, they hang me up on a door, so I'm also hanging on a door at the same time. So I'm like, what are you doing? And it was...
Probably not the most threatening you've ever been in your life.
Who do you
kicking
think
your
you
legs.
Are?
I'll get you. There's a dark side I want to explore. You've hung out some with Marilyn Manson. Let's talk about that, of course.
Well, he was in Party Monster with me. Yeah, and his character smoked in it, so he kind of wanted to learn how to smoke. And so
Marilyn Manson didn't know how to smoke?
He didn't know how to smoke. Never smoked a day in his life, he said. You know, the king, the antichrist, you know.
Yeah,
he didn't know
how
to smoke, you know.
He's like, well, it's not healthy.
Exactly.
So, praise the devil, want a cigarette?
No, it's not healthy.
So, you know, he had this very specific vision of what kind of cigarettes he wanted in his mind, so he wanted me, the avid smoker, to go with him and help him out. And so we go to the store, and he wanted Virginia Slims 100s, basically. And so that was what he wanted. So
Virginia Slims?
Virginia Slim 100s.
Isn't that kind of an old lady cigarette?
Exactly, but it was what he saw in his head. So I said, okay, cool. And I just remember we were walking out of the store. I mean, it's like he's 6'5", and I'm, you know, 5 foot, blah, blah, blah. And so... And so, and I just remember he turned to me. It was just this weird silence. He goes, you know, that's a Conan O'Brien story. He's like, you got to make sure you tell that on Conan O'Brien that I was corrupting the Antichrist. So, you know.
I love that Macaulay Culkin is convincing, you know, Marilyn Manson to have a cigarette.
Exactly.
What's happened? Now, let's talk about this movie, Saved. This is an interesting idea. It takes place at a Christian high school.
Yeah, kind of a Christian high school set in this kind of modern Christian town. And it's kind of just, I don't know, it's a fun, funny, kind of dark comedy.
Right.
With a fantastic ensemble.
How did you prepare for this movie? Did you hang out at all with Christian groups?
We went to a bunch of youth rallies and Christian rock concerts, and we went to this big one at, I think it's Edison Field in Anaheim, where the Angels play, and it's, you know, it was like, you know, it was like the U2 sound-alike rock band, or the Radiohead sound-alike rock band, they're all Christian rock bands.
They sound like those bands, but then they just throw in stuff about the loaves and the fishes.
Exactly, it's kind of uplifting, you know.
Right.
40,000 born-again Christians, who are all blonde, by the way. Just the sea of blonde born-again Christians. And I just remember, you know, walking out of that place, and it was just weird, because there was people picketing, and they were passing out all these leaflets, like, you know, don't go to this, it's, you know, terrible. And it was other Christians. These other Christians were picketing these these other Christians, and they're picking
and
each other.
They were mad that these Christians were enjoying some rock music that even had a Christian theme?
Exactly, exactly. So I just thought it was weird that, you know, if the Christians are picketing each other, what makes us think we can get away with doing a dark comedy about them, you know? So,
right.
But we'll see. I mean, I think, you know, a good amount of the Christian community has actually kind of responded to the movie, which is very good to see.
Did you get recognized at the big Christian rock show?
Yes, that was funny, you know, because it wasn't that, you know, normal, like, oh, you know, do the face, or, you know.
Right.
It was this kind of like, we're so glad you're here, you know, they really thought, like, you know, I didn't want to, like, you know, break their hearts. I'm like, yeah, I'm just here for research or something, you know. But it was just this, it was amazing. They were just so happy to see me there, you know, just like they thought I was one of them.
Right, right. You sneaky bastard.
That's me.
We have a clip here from the film. Anything we need to know to appreciate this?
Yeah, it's when I first meet Cassandra, the only Jewish girl in the whole Christian town. It's kind of when we first sit down and kind of get together, and we see our friend Mary walking out of the Planned Parenthood across the street.
Oh, okay. I set up clips like this all the time. Let's take a look at this clip from Saved. When this opens, Saved opens next Friday.
Yeah, the 28th.
Saved opens next Friday in select cities. Macaulay Culkin, thanks so much for coming
by. Thank you for having me.
He's a good man. Macaulay Culkin, we'll take a break when we come back. Dave Attell is here. Let's see, we got a fine show tonight. Fine show coming up tomorrow night from Saturday Night Live. Daryl Hammond is going to be here. From the OC, Ben McKenzie stopping by. Musical guest Switchfoot. So watch that show. We'll be right back. David Pell, too.